You mateys, welcome back to Klepto Stash, where we review the best of the best applications, extensions, add-ons, and services. And back with another application, an application that I need to use right now. And so it's very apropos that I use it right now while making this video. And that application is called Zulucrypt. Zulucrypt, a CLI and GUI front-end to crypt setup. Yes, this is cooked into the Linux kernel, so you don't have to worry about whether or not you should trust this or trust that, or whether or not the program is open source or not, and can I trust these guys or those guys? Okay, this is cooked into the Linux kernel, so you can audit it yourself. And Zulucrypt is on GitHub, so that you can audit it as well. Continuing on, let's talk all about Zulucrypt. Zulucrypt is a front-end to crypt setup and tcplay. It is a tool to make it easy to manage Luks, Plain, and TrueCrypt encrypted volumes. Zulucrypt can manage encrypted volumes residing in regular files, LVM, mdraid devices, as well as regular block devices and partitions. And it has another side of it, zuluMount. If you're making these partitions or containers, you need to mount them too. zuluMount is a front-end to Zulucrypt, and it is meant to be used as a general-purpose tool that you mount and unmount Zulucrypt-supported encrypted volumes, as well as unencrypted volumes. It can even be used as a substitute to udisks, pmount, and related tools. And so, as I said before, this is CLI and GUI. So let's jump right in, shall we? We shall. Let's see here. Zulucrypt. And recently, in their most recent release, they've added a few more encryption options and hashing options. So you have really the pick of the litter, if you will. Let's go into help. Crypto info. Let's see here. This is what they, just the default options they used to have, but now they have new options. Let's go ahead and create an encrypted container in a file. Let's call it. I'm going to be basically using this for securing my encryption keys. So we're going to say, call this one Alicia Keys. Isn't that funny? Ha ha ha. And these encryption keys aren't that big, so we're going to make it 300 meg. That's way oversized, but who cares? So it goes and goes about its business. And since the file is not large, it's going to be fairly quick. Now, as I said before, there are now many encryption options, hashing options. So I'm going to go down to twofish. Let's see here. SHA-1, SHA-256, SHA-512. The Whirlpool. Now I'm not up on my encryption options, really. So it really matter whether or not you trust AES or not, or you want to check out some other options. They have AES, they have Serpent, and Twofish. I'm going to go Twofish, and I'm going to go... Oh, I'm gonna go for this one. Key. Instead of key... Yeah, you can go key or key file. So you could keep a key file on a whole entire different server to make sure that it's secured. So you could mount it fairly easily with just one little pretty much a little script or something in terminal where you SSH to it fairly easy. But I'm gonna say key password, and yeah, oops, yeah, I love 300 plus bit passwords. They just work well for me. It's pretty much overkill, but I like overkill. Now, file system. You go ext4, ext3, vfat, ntfs, blah 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 blah. MS-DOS, riserfs, xfs. Yeah, I'll do ext4, why not? Need a little journaling going on. Say create. Now it goes about its business. Success! Volume created successfully. Creating a backup of the Luks volume header is also strongly advised. And we know about that. And you can do that as well within this application. Please read documentation on why this is important. Now, I'm going to say open encrypted container in a file. And we're going to go find said file, Alicia keys. And you can also open the volume in read-only mode if you just want to copy out some files, but we want to add some files here. So, I put in my key. And for those of you who watch my YouTube channel, I did a video on auto key. And what you just saw there is I have a nice little macro set up for long passwords, particularly long passwords, a few of them. And I just type in a short name for it, and it automatically adds that password to it. So I don't have to try to remember the password or try to find it somewhere. It's fairly easy to do, and I have a lot of them from very different purposes or a different URL. Go back and check it out. Auto key video. It's on my YouTube channel. Now, hit open. Bingo, boom, shakalaka. And there it is. So, let's see here. Whoops. Go here. Jesus Christ, it's just opening everywhere. Okay. Run. Let's see. Run. Media private. Private. Klepto. Leash keys. There it is. Okay. Like I said, there's the information right there. And I can just go ahead and copy files over to it. Now, I don't want you to know where my encryption keys are, do I? No, that's private information. You need not know that. All you need to know is that you can do it too, just like me. Whatever you want to put in there. Let's just say you want to put a bunch of files in there. You just need to back up and slap it over on Dropbox or slap it wherever you want to slap it. Okay? And if you got a good password, or maybe a password plus a key, you can also add extra key files and stuff to it to secure it. It's going to be very difficult for anybody to access that information, depending on how you have it set up. And there you go. That is Zulucrypt. And there's so much more to Zulucrypt. Let's get into a little bit of the features here. Encrypt a file, decrypt a file, erase data in the device. You can create an encrypted partition, open the partition, add a key to a volume, delete a key to a volume, back up the header, restore the headers. It's very nice. And really the headers, backup headers is important just in case the file gets corrupted. And so you can go and restore those headers and make sure that your encrypted volume or encrypted partition is back the way it was originally. And it has some options on managing volumes and internal wallet. GNOME, KDE, wallet, whatever have you. A very nice program. Another very nice program is TOMB. T-O-M-B. You can find it in the Arch user repositories and elsewhere. Great bunch of guys there make some great software. That particular software is for terminal only. They do have, I think, a couple Python scripts for GUI, but it's basically terminal only. And for us idiots out here who sometimes need a little GUI action, man, Zulucrypt and zuluMount is it. Very nice. Go check it out. Go pick it up. And tell the developer of Zulucrypt, who's a very cool guy, that Klepto and Klepto's Dash told you all about it. Now, let me go about my business, and we'll do this again very soon.